Welcome to the Travel Agent Podcast. I'm your host, Aileen Blanco. I interview successful industry professionals and share my personal journey to becoming a travel agent. The show is for aspiring travel agents and travel professionals at every level. My mission is to uncover the universal keys to thrive in this business. Join me as I take a closer look into the life of a travel agent. Hello and welcome. Today's guest is Minnie. She is going to give us a quick introduction to herself, and we're going to learn a little bit about her as we get into our interview. Minnie?
Hi. How's it going, guys? I'm Minnie from Paddy Camp Travel. I started in the travel industry about, I want to say, 4 years ago. It was kind of like a quick turn in career change. I went to school for kinesiology in San Francisco, but traveling has always been my passion. So I kind of wanted to work in something that I loved. So that's why I became a travel agent. I love my job most of the time, like everybody else, but it's an awesome industry to be in. I'm very fortunate and happy.
Awesome. So what exactly sparked your interest? What was the aha moment when you're like, I'm going to be a travel agent?
So I've always been interested in travel and like learning new things, going and visiting new places. And I wasn't sure that travel agencies or travel agents were still a thing. I was 23 when I kind of like started thinking into like doing a career in travel, but then I did other things. And I think it was to a point where some of my mom's brothers traveled with travel agents, but there was only one in the area where I grew up on. So like I always used to hear like they complaining about the travel agent or like something happened and blaming the travel industry and blaming the travel agent, obviously. I was like, what's going on? Let me get into this a little bit more. And that's when I actually worked with her for like 2 years and kind of learned the business, but that wasn't my first industry job. But it was just one day where I was like, okay, that's it. I want to work in something that I really, really love. And it was pretty much, I was working with my dad at the moment. So that day I was like, Dad, that's it. I'm going to be a travel agent. But that's like, they don't even exist anymore. I'm like, I'm going to prove you wrong. And I sure did.
That's awesome. That's so awesome. Well, I'm glad that you found out that we do exist.
Yeah.
You have been in the business longer than me. What has been something that was that you failed or was a huge lesson for you that you were able to overcome when you first started your business?
So when I first started, it was really hard to. I don't want to say I failed, but it was really hard to like set boundaries. I mean, I still don't have a lot of boundaries with my clients, but. You have that like eagerness to please everybody all the time. And you feel like there's a lot of things in our industry that we don't have control over. So I kind of wanted to like reconfirm and make sure that every single thing on my clients' trips were going to be perfect. So I kind of have to like, now I still work on that. It's kind of hard, but like I have to set realistic goals and be like, okay, like, I'm not God. If the weather is bad and your flight is delayed, there's nothing I can really do about it. Like, I can call you and make you calm down a little bit, but I'm not going to control the airports or the airlines. And I think that's one of my biggest obstacles to, like, realize and let go that even though we work really hard and we reconfirm and have everything in writing and try to do everything, mistake free, there's going to be things that are completely out of our control.
That's so true.
Yes. I'm pretty sure you can relate.
For sure. So what is one thing that you are most excited about right now in your business?
Right now in my business, I feel like I'm at the point and I'm really excited and nervous at the same time, but I'm at the point where I have a lot of clients, thank God, and I'm getting so busy that I need help. So I get nervous because I like being in control, but now actually my mom is helping me with a lot of work-related things. So I feel like I'm at a point in my career when I'm going to start to grow a little bit more and make it not only my business, but I can even become like a family business. And so that's something that I'm really excited about.
Awesome. I love it when we have family help, but it's so awesome. And I understand, completely scary. We're ready to bring on someone and really have like a full on business that's not just yours. So that's exciting. Mm-hmm. I'm super excited for you, and I can't wait to hear more about the growth of your business. So what's some of the best advice you've received so far?
I think best advice that I have received is that was from my first job in the travel industry. My boss would used to like always tell me, cover your butt. Whatever you do, make sure that you're always covering it, either by an email or always, because like I said, we can't have control over everything, but at least if something happens, we know we're covered. That's one. And the second thing is kind of like letting go of that expectation that we can't be perfect in our, not in life. In life, it's fine not being perfect, but in our jobs.
CYA is important. and it's true. Like, I think pretty much everyone I've spoken with, we all have the same issue. Like, we truly want our clients to have an amazing experience. And, you know, we can do everything we can possibly do. And, you know, and if the weather's bad, if, you know, the staff is bad or something goes wrong, there's nothing we can do. But it is nice that they have someone that they can come to and vent, and, you know, we can do our very best to make a bad situation better. So, I'm really glad that that is something, it's across the board that we all have to work on. And, I'm sure, you know, it gets easier. So, as far as like habits and mindset, is there anything that you do every single day, any habits, that have contributed to the success of your business?
I think, I recently, like maybe 2 or 3 months ago, I started meditating in the mornings and at night, if not, I can't sleep. And it's so helpful to wake up kind of rested and start your day. Because if not, there's so many things that we're thinking about, even if we do our to-do list and we have our emails and any other form that other agents kind of like organize their life. But if we're not mentally relaxed, then it's going to be really hard. And exercise. I try to do exercise every day. It's kind of hard because you want to check your email and do other things. But I do try to exercise a lot.
Exercise and meditation. That's great. So are there any specific like systems that you use? Any type of organizational systems, CRMs or any type of those that you find helpful?
Sorry, I use ClientBase, which is really helpful. There's a lot of tools on ClientBase that that can actually make your life easier. At the beginning when I was using it, I don't think I knew the tools that they had. So now, like, just starting to get everything organized. If you get a new client, like, step one, do their profile on ClientBase. Get all that information. If they send you their passport info, if they send you the credit card information, it goes on ClientBase first thing. Because at the beginning, it was such a mess to like, okay, like I have, and then I work with a lot of Mexican clients because that's my background. So it was either credit cards on WhatsApp, phone calls on Facebook, and like everything was just such a mess. So I think now having that rule of going straight to ClientBase has made my work life easier. And I also should be doing my invoices right away after every sale, which I don't do. That's a working process. But same thing, everything's on client base. And then my to-do list, I used to do other apps to organize myself, but I feel the easiest one is just doing an Excel worksheet and working from there. Mm-hmm. Kind of old school.
So is there anything that that I missed that you feel is really important to being a travel agent that we haven't talked about already?
Ooh, I think expectations is the beginning. We kind of feel like, ooh, or everybody tells you, you're a travel agent, you're traveling the world, that's your job. Yeah, it's part of our job, but at the end of the day, if we don't sell it, if we're not in front of our computer working super hard, because it's not an easy job, you're not going to make any money. So you're not going to, you might be traveling, but then you're going to come home and you're not going to have any money at all. So I think managing expectations of what to do, your clients also, because there's a lot of times where you just be like, oh, I'm going to sell travel, I'm going to be rich. If you're in this industry for the money, I don't think it's going to work out in the first probably 10 years, because it's a lot of work, and it's probably, I don't think our days are 8-hour work days. They're probably like 24/7 work days. So we're probably making like $2 an hour or something. But it's a difference that work really hard at the beginning. Maybe it's not a lot of money, but we're in love with our jobs in a way. So
yeah, I think that managing the expectation of your clients and your own personal expectations are really important. I have noticed, you know, that I get the same thing. You're traveling, you're doing all of these things. It's like, my joy comes from helping other people, you know, live out their travel dreams. And yes. So if you have the right mindset and you set the right expectations, I think that overall, you may not be a millionaire, but it really is mm-hmm. satisfying, even though it is 24/7.
Yes, of course. I do a lot of honeymoons, and I feel like it's, I love when I talk to the couple and they're so in love and happy and like excited for everything, right? For what's to come. And sometimes they kind of forget about the honeymoon, but I feel like it's my job to remind them that it's the best part of the wedding. So it's really cool how like they're talking about like the wedding and their stress and the flowers. And then like they sit in front of me and we talk about any like destination that they want to go to, and their eyes just like light up. So I feel like that's one of the best parts of my job that I love.
Awesome. Well, it has been amazing talking to you today. I'm so thankful for you to do the podcast. Is there anything that is going on in your business that you want to tell the audience?
Yes. So for next year, either February or March, I'm working on setting the date. I'm going to have a group tour to South Africa. It's like I mentioned, I usually do honeymoons, but I'm starting to do more group tours of like-minded people, maybe like professional age group, which is kind of cool too, because sometimes we feel like we don't have, either our friends are married or they're going through other stuff, or like you can't really travel with your friends. So what better way of exploring the world with people that love to travel to and they're kind of like in the same mindset. So that information will be coming up shortly, I promise. So we can start working on that group tour.
And so where can they find you?
My website is Padicam Travel. It's Padicam is my two last names put together. It's kind of like a family thing. So it's PADICAM.com. And also on Facebook, I'm under Padicam Travel as well. But all the information that's going to go on Facebook is going straight to the website.
Awesome. Well, thank you again for coming to the show today. And make sure you guys check out Padicam.com. And we will be back next week. Thank you for joining the Travel Agent Podcast. Don't forget to subscribe, rate, and review.
Visit the travelagentpodcast.com for more information about today's episode and other travel agent resources. Be sure to tune in every Thursday for new episodes. Until next time, continue to build a travel business you love.